It's shortly after noon on May 3, 2016. At the Grand Strand Airport in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, a pilot and two friends are preparing to fly home to Central Connecticut after a weekend getaway. 66 years old, the ATP-rated pilot has over 4,000 hours of flight time, much of it in November 440 Hotel, the Beach V-35 Bonanza he's owned for nearly 30 years. The extent of his recent flight experience is unclear, but given his conversation with flight service earlier in the day, there's no reason to think that today's flight will present any particular challenge.
Good morning, flight service. Can I help you?
Make the rain and the fog go away.
All right, we'll do our best.
All right.
Okay, basically you're traveling right along a stationary front that runs from the mid-Atlantic down into Mobile area there, and fairly widespread areas of rain showers and thunderstorms along that front, and also widespread IFR ceilings and visibilities. Looking en route here, you've got IFR to low IFR conditions basically up across the bulk of that route of flight, and then on into the Connecticut area. All right, they're forecasting 1,500 to 2,000 overcast tops in the flight levels, visibilities 3 miles, rain and mist. That's good pretty much all day long. Anyway, it looks like you're going to be in the weather the bulk of that of the flight. Right, is there anything else I can get for you, sir?
No. Just have it be on the upper side of all those forecasts.
All right, appreciate it, Pop. Have a great day, so long.
The pilot files an IFR flight plan to Plainville, Connecticut, listing Hartford, 10 miles northeast, as his alternate. The flight will take a little over 3 hours. At 12:40 p.m., Bonanza 440 Hotel departs Myrtle Beach with 5 hours of fuel and is soon established in cruise at 7,000 MSL. For the first 2 hours and 20 minutes, everything is routine. But shortly after 3 p.m., with the aircraft flying above an overcast south of Long Island, the pilot calls New York TRACON with a troubling report.
New York approach Bonanza 440 Hotel, with you 7,000.
440 Hotel, New York, can you alter Miss 2983?
2983, Bonanza 440 Hotel. And yes, sir, we've lost our vacuum system for our gyros.
And 440 Hotel, what is the problem?
We've lost our vacuum system for our gyros or partial panel, 440 Hotel. We're VFR on top right now. We'd like it's the easiest approach to get down to the clouds at our destination as possible.
Okay, so you declare an emergency now?
We're partial panel, 440 Hotel.
Okay, so do you want to declare an emergency or not? And 440 Hotel, send and maintain 5,000.
Sir, we prefer to stay at 7,000. We're at VFR right now. I don't want to go down into the clouds.
Sounds good.
Oh, I thought you said you wanted to descend. You want to stay at 7?
Affirmative, sir. 440 Hotel. I might descend to the destination. I would like to, hopefully, we're fairly clear going down into my destination.
Okay, right, sir. And 440 Hotel, just to verify, are you declaring an emergency?
Yes, sir. 440 Hotel.
And 440 Hotel, you want to continue on to his destination? You want to continue on to your destination?
Yes, sir. I think the weather is better there than it is right here at my current location. I haven't been able to check that far away yet. So the Hartford area or Bradley area, Bonanza 440 Hotel.
Given the situation, the pilot's initial response to the equipment failure was understandable. Less than an hour from his destination, in the middle of a large weather system, his focus was naturally on getting home. At the same time, his desire to remain clear of clouds and his acceptance of emergency services showed an awareness of the problem. What it didn't show was an understanding of just how much danger he faced. Partial panel flying is a staple of instrument training, but after the check ride, it's a skill that tends to atrophy. It's also a skill that's rarely practiced under realistic conditions. During training, gyroscopic instruments fail instantly, their faces covered by suction cups or post-it notes. But in the real world, and especially in older aircraft, the tiny suction gauge on the far side of the panel quietly registers a decline and the instruments fail slowly. In IMC, it can be difficult to figure out what's happening before things go badly wrong. And once things have gone wrong in a partial panel situation, it's almost impossible to recover. The pilot of 440 Hotel at least had the good fortune to experience his failure in VMC. He may have been able to cover the failed instruments. We don't know. But whatever the case, it's clear he didn't understand the gravity of the situation. It's now 3:29 p.m., just a few minutes after the initial exchange with ATC, and the pilot is explaining his situation to a new controller.
Bonanza 440 Hotel, New York, I understand you're in an emergency. Can you tell me the nature of the emergency and do you require any assistance?
We're partial panel, sir. We're fine. We're VFR over the top right now, and we just want to make sure that we don't have a whole bunch of flying in the clouds, partial panel, to get down below the clouds.
And 440 Hotel, I understand that you're not in dire need of extra service, but you said, what's again the nature?
Partial panel, we've lost our vacuum system, sir.
Partial or vac system loss, okay, thank you. And you still want to continue to the destination, yes or no?
I believe the weather is better at my destination, so if I have a higher ceiling there, then I would like to continue to my destination out to Hartford and to 440 Hotel.
A few minutes later, the pilot calls back with a request.
Yes, sir. Can you get me the current weather for Hartford by there?
Hartford, stand by. And November 4, New Hotel, the weather at Hartford, observation is, it's an automated, so it's 19130. The wind is 020 at 6, visibility 10, and it's 1,600 overcast. The temperature is 12, deep winds 9, and the altimeter is 2983 at Hartford.
Bonanza
440 Hotel, are you going to continue towards Hartford?
I'm not sure what I have for a better alternative,
Bonanza 440
Hotel.
Bonanza 440 Hotel, I'm looking at all the closest airports at this time, and it does look like Hartford does have the best weather with a 1,600 overcast ceiling.
Apparently assuming that his intended destination has similar weather, the pilot requests vectors to the Plainville Airport for Bravo 8.
November 4-0 Hotel, proceed to my Bridgeport, and we'll get you on course.
4-0 Hotel, roger. And your IFC this time, sir. 4-0 Hotel.
Okay, just let me advise me if you need anything else.
I'm clear, guys. You get 4-0 Hotel.
I can't do that. I wish I could.
The first item to note here is the pilot again explaining his situation to a controller who seems not to really grasp the problem. We can say two things. First, this seems to be a common issue with controllers, many of whom are not pilots themselves, and who may only rarely handle light aircraft. Second, it's the pilot's job to erase any doubt about the nature of the emergency. This is no time to worry about technical descriptions. Just tell ATC what's going on and what you need. For example, I've lost critical flight instruments, and I need to stay clear of clouds. Seen in that context, the pilot's report of entering IMC is troubling. The controller doesn't offer a climb, indicating that he still doesn't really understand the situation, and the pilot doesn't request one. Why is hard to say. The aircraft was still 70 miles from its destination. It's conceivable that the pilot wanted to practice prior to the actual descent, but nothing was said about it. More likely, he was resigned to the situation and just going along, and in doing so, essentially choosing to make things worse. It's now 3:38 p.m., and things are not going well.
4-0-10, direct Bridgeport, Bravo Delta Romeo, please. Bravo Delta Romeo, it appears that you're southbound. 4-0-10, New York.
4-0-10, roger, sir. I just lost a little bit more control over here.
Okay, 4-0-10, turn left to left, turning 060.
Turning left to 060, 4-0-10.
4-0-10, would you like a lower altitude? Bonanza 7-0-10, how can I be of assistance?
Yes, sir, we're working on it. We just lost more of our panel, that's all. 4-0 Hotel, we're turning to 060, and we're trying to get back to 7,000.
It's okay, just if you need a block altitude, just keep me advised, I'll protect for you.
4-0 Hotel, thank you.
Over the next 2 minutes, radar shows the aircraft turning more than 90 degrees off course before correcting. The controller volunteers conditions at nearby Republic Airport.
And 7-0 Hotel, the Republic observation is 1853. The wind is 0407, visibility is 3 miles, broken, and 700 overcast. Let's just try to land at Republic.
By this time, though, the aircraft has entered a steep spiral, descending over 4,000 feet in 20 seconds.
And November 4-0 Hotel, radar contact lost. November 4-0 Hotel, low altitude alert, 90 miles north-northwest of Republic. MVA is 1,600. November 4-0 Hotel, New York approach.
There is no reply. On the ground, witnesses describe hearing a loud bang and seeing an airplane emerge from the clouds in several pieces. Investigators find debris scattered along a path nearly a half mile long. Sometimes in emergency situations, the entire outcome hinges on the pilot's actions in the moment. Think of Sully ditching in the Hudson River, or the crew of United Flight 232, whose quick thinking and never-say-die attitude saved hundreds of lives in Sioux City, Iowa. In some situations, though, our fate is essentially sealed long before the emergency makes itself known. The loss of November 440 Hotel falls into that category. In one sense, it was entirely avoidable. And yet, for that pilot, on that day, and under those circumstances, a tragic outcome was all too likely. But why? The pilot's proficiency was the most obvious factor. We have no training records, but the ATC radar track, along with the fact that only 3 or 4 minutes elapsed between the aircraft entering IMC and breaking up, make it clear that, whatever the pilot's opinion of his own abilities, he was woefully unprepared to fly the aircraft in a real-life partial panel situation. The next factor was the size of the weather system. When the vacuum pump failed, the aircraft had a little over 2 hours of fuel remaining, while the nearest conditions that might have allowed a VFR descent were roughly an hour and a half away. That would have been a stretch, but under the circumstances, a long diversion to potentially better weather was clearly the better option, and also one the pilot was unlikely to choose. He obviously felt some degree of confidence in his partial panel skills, and his actions, beginning with the selection of an alternate only 10 miles from his primary airport, show that his focus was on getting home and that potential problems were far from his mind. The vacuum pump was the next factor. At the time of the accident, the pump was 17 years old and had been in operation 373 hours. A manufacturer's service letter called for replacement at 6 years or 500 hours, whichever came first. Dry vacuum pumps are relatively fragile, and their components do degrade with age alone, an inconvenient fact that aircraft owners shrug off at their peril. The other aspect of vacuum failure was the aircraft's total lack of backup systems. Aircraft used for IFR typically have standby pumps and/or electrically powered attitude and heading indicators. Some have simple backups that pull suction from the intake manifold. None of these were installed in 440 Hotel. We don't know how often the pilot flew IFR, but doing so without any form of backup was asking for trouble. The term single point of failure refers to a system in which the loss of a single component can, by itself, lead to a catastrophic outcome. In theory, a vacuum pump-equipped aircraft flown by a proficient instrument pilot is not such a system. Even without a secondary vacuum source or standby instrumentation, there's still a backup, the pilot. Too often, though, the pilot is not up to the task. When that's the case, the vacuum pump becomes a single point of failure every time the aircraft enters IMC. It's a risk no passenger would knowingly agree to, and one that we as pilots have an obligation to avoid.